Olympics, Australia's Shane Gould established herself as one of the greatest swimming legends this country has produced. She returned with a haul of 5 medals, and Brooke Bavell caught up with her to find out what she's been doing since.
But I can't live in the past. I have to live right here and now and prepare for tomorrow. I can reflect on the past and learn from my mistakes and my experiences and take the skills I've learned from the past, but I can't stay back there. You know, there's more to life. You know, I was, 15 years old at the Olympics. Can you imagine someone who say, oh, my life's ended, that's all I can achieve. That's the pinnacle of my life.
Shane Gould in lane 3 attempted to become the highest gold medal history.
1972, the Munich Olympics, and the Shane Gould show was about to begin.
And away they go to a perfect start. Shane came up swimming very well indeed. She's already in front just by a touch or so.
3 gold, 1 silver and 1 bronze medal later, the Tarahumara teenager had rewritten the record books, winning the most individual gold medals by an Australian woman at an Olympics.
The clock's up to 1:58. She's going to the line. She's just over 2 minutes. Shane's in front. She's flying towards the line. And Shane Gould's won. It's a world record. 23.56. A world record for Shane Gould.
It was a remarkable beginning to what many thought heralded a new generation in Australian swimming. Dawn Fraser's career was all but destroyed, and now our Shane would fill the void. But Gould had something different in mind, and within a year did the unthinkable. She retired.
Gould, now her third gold medal. She equals the performance of Debbie Meyer.
Certainly I turned my back on it, and in a sense I've... But you can't help but it influenced your whole life. Shane Gould is, synonymous with swimming. It just has been said too many times. I've been filmed and photographed too many times, so I can't look, I can't walk away from it. It's not possible. But what I did in turning my back on it was looking for more to life. I said there's more to winning gold medals and being at the Olympic Games, and I found more.
South of Perth in Western Australia, the wine-growing district of Margaret River. It was here that Shane Gould began her new life, far away from the intense spotlight of international competition. It's a country life. Now 37 years old with 4 children, Shane and her husband Neil Innes run a 38-hectare property. Their main source of income, training horses.
A 5-year-old should be able to put a bridle on this horse.
We're communicating with a horse the way another horse would communicate with it.
It's long, hard, hot work. Hour upon hour of patiently working with the animals. And while way out of the glare of the public spotlight, her dedication is as intense as it was all those years ago when she was in the pool.
It was always me against the clock, really. Some people say I had a killer instinct,
You had a killer instinct?
Oh, I was very determined to win, and I think I had an attitude to, to win, but not at all costs.
And when the cost outweighed the benefits, Gould knew it was time to move on.
I quit because I didn't see any more purpose in training and... breaking more world records and winning more medals. I had a hunch that there was more to life, and I wanted to know what that was. And I think I'm a bit greedy about life. I want to have lots of experiences and learn.
Gould was 16 when she retired from swimming, a decision which also took its toll.
I had bouts of depression and confusion and anger, and I've read some information about some studies done in Canada about that elite sports people can experience this type of stress that is like a death. It's a grief management thing, really.
In the end, it was her Christian faith and her family that brought her peace. In 1981, awarded an MBE for her services to swimming, Gould said she deserved it more for being a mother than for winning races.
To them, I'm their mum. Now, that's the main thing. I'm mum. And it's secondary. And they see there's a lot of fuss about, you know, much ado about nothing, I suppose.
The water still plays a big role in Gould's life, but these days she prefers riding the waves to ploughing up and down a pool.
My husband Neil, you know, it was the scene where the women sat on the beach, you know, being, you know, beautiful, and I couldn't cope just sitting on the beach, so I got out and body surfed amongst the surfers, and they said, oh, you're too dangerous, here, have a board. Angle across the wave a little bit. Some of you have tried that already, but you understand what I mean by angling across?
For the past few years, she's been passing on some of the knowledge and water skills she's learnt at the Leaps and Bounds weekend surfing camps in Margaret River.
You know, I'm really impressed with you all, I really am. And I think it's great what you're doing, and I encourage you to keep having a try.
And whether her young surfing protégés realise just how great a sporting champion Gould was is irrelevant to her. She's found her place, and it's a place she's happy with.
People say I'm a legend.
Do you think of yourself as a legend?
Not really, but I accept that other people perceive me as that, so I try and behave like one and have make sure I have things to offer people apart from just being some historical thing that's stuck in
there. And Shane Gould's won! It's a world record!
Great story. Interesting to see great sporting achievements in the context of an entire life. Well, the Masters, well, it's really, really hotting up, and this afternoon is going to be fantastic. Bruce has dragged Jack Newton out of bed to talk about it after the break.
Let's hope he produces the goods.
Norman at 11, Jack.
He's got it! Hello!
Is this the start?